Yo, what up, man? It's your boy Chris. Somebody's review checking in, man. Total Slaughter debuted last night, man. You know, a lot of expectations. You heard all the rumors, man. It was the biggest battle event of the year.
Okay.
Lux and Mook would be the battle of the year.
Okay.
Eminem was gonna be there and flip the coin for the Lux and Mook battle.
Okay.
Total Slaughter is taking over the battle culture.
Okay.
They taking over UW.
Okay.
They taking over King of the Dot.
Okay.
They taking over URL.
Oh my God! URL is over!
Yeah, man, we pretty much heard all the rumors, man. And you know, I'm gonna make this a real short recap. It's like everybody has pretty much done a Total Slaughter recap. So we pretty much saying the same thing. I think it was a lot of disappointment in the outcome. To whom much is given, much is required. And Total Slaughter came out wanting to say that they were the number one battle lead. They were gonna be push the culture so much forward. So of course, they're gonna be open to criticism, you know what I'm saying? So I was just as disappointed as a lot of people. I had DirecTV, I couldn't order this shit through my television, so I had to get online. I had the same issues everybody else had with the whole error code and everything. I don't know what was going on with the pay-per-view. That shit wasn't working. It was definitely a disappointment. I had to go on fucking Twitter and Facebook and see all these niggas talking about how they seeing these battles and watching these battles or whatever, and it was just like I couldn't even see shit. So that shit was disappointing, because I could have been doing some other shit on a Saturday night, you know what I'm saying, in Atlanta. It's a lot of shit to do. I could have been doing some other shit had I known I was not going to be able to see Total Slaughter. So that was a disappointment. Shout out to the nigga that put it on YouTube, though. I ain't really want to support bootleg, but shout out to you. That was the only way I was able to see it. So niggas was posting his link everywhere on Twitter and Facebook. So shout out to you, my nigga. Yeah, I think Total Slaughter got a lot to learn, man. It's not easy putting on battle events, man. Salute to the people like King of the Dot, URL, people that's been doing this consistently for such a long time. It's not an easy job.
You have to understand, man. This battle, doing these battles, it's just hard work. You know what I'm saying? Like, people think they're just gonna come in, do these battles, and oh, we're gonna be better than them, and just take over, whatever the case may be.
One thing I will say, man, a couple things that just stood out right away. The audio could have been a lot better. It was hard to hear Big T. It was off. Hollow the Don was also complaining about the audio after the battle. Big T was complaining about the audio after the battle. That could have been a lot better. As far as the stage, they had the stage in the middle. They had a crowd around. They kind of had like everybody looking down. I think that was a bad idea also, because having it that way, you really couldn't have no entourages on stage, because they would have blocked the view of the other people that were surrounding the stage. And to be honest with you, man, as much as we complain about crowds, as much as we complain about entourages and the stage is too crowded, it looked a little boring on the stage without having nobody up there, just to be real with you. You need to be able to capture the essence of a battle, and you gotta have some crowd members, some entourages, something behind a battle rapper. Just seeing two people stand up there, it just made the stage look boring, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just some things are just a staple to battle rap, man. Niggas screaming, get that nigga Rex behind every Dot My battle.
So St. Louis, don't cheat me and say y'all man won. Cause that's exactly what the judge gonna give me. Man one, murder in the first degree with a handgun.
Let's go, Rex!
Get that nigga Rex!
Poison Pen faces, Jazz the Rapper faces, even my nigga Steamly, his faces be crazy in these battles. Mickey Fax saying that shit was hard. You know,
like Rocky, when he boxed with Apollo. If he dies, he dies. I got the cards as a Drago. Headshot, life support. If he try to survive though, I treat through the hospital and pull a cord on him. I give him that Macho Camacho.
What I'm saying, we all know Mickey Fast got the faces in the battles as well. Who else are we missing? Conceited with the Edom. You know what I'm saying? We missed Edom yesterday, man. We need these entourages and these niggas on the state.
Edom!
Alright, look.
Conceited, Edom. You know what I'm saying? We miss these people on the stage, man. We gotta have at least a little bit of an entourage. It don't gotta be crowded, but just having two people stand up there with nobody up there, I think it took a little bit away from the battle as well. And one of the things that was probably the most disappointing, man, just on a side note, you know what I'm saying? Not really too much attached to the battles per se, but I was disappointed that they actually hired Ebro to host this event, because if you go back to like a year ago, he was on Twitter really dissing battle rap, saying that he didn't really fuck with battle rap, that battle rap didn't really make sense and it was stupid and it wasn't good. You know what I'm saying? He just didn't support it. I don't even have these tweets, so I will reshow them. But a year ago, he was saying this shit as a Hot 97 program director, a big face in battle rap. A lot of dudes that came up in New York, Jay-Z, DMX, niggas like that, they came up on the battle rap era. He basically was dissing the battle rap culture. URL, Norbs, and Smack invited him out to Gnome 3 so he can kind of get integrated in today's culture. He didn't take the opportunity. He never came out to Gnome 3, but then he shows up at Slaughterhouse. Why? Because these niggas paid him to come out there. You know what I'm saying? It's not even like he really fucked with the culture. That nigga was getting a check. And for y'all to go out and hire him, you got to stop throwing money at the culture just so this shit'll look good. Oh, we gonna have K Slay there, and we gonna have Sway there, and we gonna have Ebro there, and we gonna have Busta Rhymes there, and we gonna have all these niggas there. But at the same time, man, you gotta have niggas that really fuck with the culture, and Ebro, he just don't fuck with the culture. I was disappointed that they actually had him in such a prominent role as far as like hosting the event. You know what I'm saying? Not like they couldn't invite the nigga, but they actually hired a nigga to host. So I felt disappointed to even see that as a battle rap fan, just knowing what the shit he said a year ago. So that was one thing, man. As far as these battles, man, Arsenal versus Big T. Arsenal won 3-0. I thought Big T had a pretty decent first round. You might even want to give him the first round, maybe 2-1. Definitely a clear win from Arsenal. As far as Big T, man, I'm a big supporter of Big T. I fuck with him heavy. He been having some bad battles lately. I'm going to keep it a stack. His B-Magic battle ain't dropped. That is not a good battle. His Big Cannon battle really wasn't a good battle, considering that he choked. In this particular battle, man, and we can even go back to the old Red and K-Shine battle, even though he had a couple good rounds versus K-Shine. Those big crowds are really hurting Big T. I'm not going to go as far and say that he's overrated or none of that. Like, he's just a closed room battle rapper. That's all it is at the end of the day. When it comes to these bigger rooms, it's just like, maybe he overthinks himself, overwrites. Whatever it is, it's just not the Big T we're accustomed to. And I just feel like he just need to take a break, regroup, and go back to small rooms. It is what it is. Shout out to Arsenal. He did his thing. Arsenal is made for this shit, man. You know what I'm saying? He can battle on any arena, any stage, and do his thing. He's a performer. He's an entertainer. Clear win for Arsenal. He was my MVP of the night as far as having the best showing. So salute to him. T-Rex and Daylight. This was already going to be a bad battle from the start. Everybody know Rex and Daylight fuck with each other. It was I ain't going to say a matchup, because they pretty much went through the Slaughterhouse tournament, so they had to put them together because they were the two finalists. But we already knew it was going to be a bad battle. Daylight on his bullshit as usual with the third round. You know what I'm saying? To be honest with you, man, I'm through with Daylight. Shout out to the Untold Truth. I fuck with Daylight. I'm happy he gave me the interview. I felt like I got a chance to get to know him, a different side of him, and the interview is getting crazy views. I can't support no antics that this nigga do. You know what I'm saying? And leagues need to really stop booking this nigga. They just need to stop booking this nigga. Just point blank. That's just my personal opinion, because for every battle we get, like Chilla Jones and Daylight, we get some bullshit. And it's just like, you know what I'm saying? He just don't take enough shit serious. And unless he can get serious, and the fans really made him this way, because we've accepted his behavior for so long that the nigga just don't give a fuck no more. I'm not supporting no more antics from Daylight, nothing. Like, that shit is not even cool. When he want to spit some bars, I fuck with him. But other than that, when there wasn't no people on the stage, Rex was just walking around. That's what happened when you don't have no entourages and no people. This nigga Daylight is at the front of the stage rapping. Rex is like in the back, just standing there. You know what I'm saying? Nigga ain't even around Daylight. So that shit was crazy, man. But T-Rex clearly won that battle. Shout out to Rex for that. And it wasn't a good battle, man, but Rex clearly won. Lux and Murder Mook, this was the battle of the night for me going into the event. You know, I was definitely anticipating this battle, looking forward to it. I thought the first round was close. You can get Lux the first round, Mook the first round. I thought it was kind of a toss-up. You know what I'm saying? After that, niggas just stopped fucking with Lux. I just think his style and the whole nine, it wore really, really thin on the crowd. The crowd was kind of a mixture of industry people and battle rap fans, and that shit just didn't mix. If you look out, man, with a lot of chicks in the crowd, a lot of white guys in the crowd, you know, a lot of different ethnicities, you know, no disrespect to them, but you just normally don't see that in your typical URL, UW type battle. So just seeing that, you can tell it was very diverse, and they just wasn't really fucking with Loaded Lux after the first round, to be real with you. And Murder Mook does what Murder Mook does, man. He breaks niggas down, no matter whether you like his style or not. He breaks you down and really studies his opponent. So I thought he had a pretty good battle. I'm not going to go over the top and say it was great, because it wasn't great to me, but it was good. You know what I'm saying? He was definitely good in this battle. He showed that he can definitely fuck with the new era, in my opinion. You know, a lot of niggas were like, oh, I want to see him battle Surf. I want to see him battle Verb. I don't think them niggas can fuck with him. Now DNA doing freestyles. He want to battle Murder Mook. Like, yo, leave Mook alone, my nigga. You know, like, niggas don't need to battle this nigga because this nigga really studies you, breaks you down, and uses your style against you. And that's pretty much what he did with Loaded Lux. But Loaded Lux felt real, he looked real uncomfortable on stage. I'm going to be real, had his hands on his hips and shit like that and talking about his fucking haircut. I don't know what the fuck this nigga was talking about. So it just didn't seem like the typical Loaded Lux battle. I'm not going to go over the top and act like the nigga's done. Like, niggas, you know, the thing about this battle rap culture, man, you only as good as your last battle, my nigga. Niggas are now going back and saying he wasn't even good against Hollow, and niggas are straight tripping because the nigga was dope against Hollow. But you know what I'm saying? Loaded Lux just needs to regroup, maybe even go back to the Gun Bar Loaded Lux back in the day. But I think people are just tired of his style. Niggas are breaking down his style. And every time he calls somebody a lost nigga, it's like they turning a lost nigga angle on him. You know what I'm saying? So that shit ain't even working out for him. So shout out to Mook. A lot of niggas got Mook 3-0. I'm cool with that. You can give Lux the first round and say Mook 2-1 either way. They hired judges for this whole event, but the event was so lopsided that you really didn't need judges but like for like one battle. So Mook clearly won that battle. That's pretty much that battle. Follow the Don and Joe Budden. This battle was disappointing to me. You know what I'm saying? I do think it was debatable. I think had Joe Budden not have ended his round, his third round so bad, I think niggas probably would have gave this battle to Joe Budden, to be real with you. I don't really care who you give it to. I didn't really feel like it was a good Hollow to Don battle. It's probably one of his worst battles I've seen, maybe since the Hitman battle, because I didn't really like his Hitman battle that much. But he just kind of went with the bully role, like I'll slap you for slapping a girl, or I should punch you for slapping a girl. Like, he kind of like went that bully route, and his bars wasn't really hitting that much to me. That's just me personally. I'm a big Hollow fan, but I felt like he dropped the ball on a few bars in this particular battle. He had a nice Jagged Edge 112 line, though. Like, when he went through the whole R&B groups, that shit was cold. But he was hit or miss here and there. Joe Budden, he was rapping like he was reading from a paper or writing a song or whatever. But he did have some shit here and there. A lot of niggas feel like he might have won this battle, and I can't even really argue with that. The judges picked Hollow to Don, man, and I ain't arguing with that either. We got judges for a reason. Who am I to argue with them? You know what I'm saying? It was close, so you can go either way. But I don't like the way Joe Budden ended his round. I felt like it was poor sportsmanship. And for you to be part of Total Slaughter or Slaughterhouse and actually have a battle league and be part of a battle league, you can't lead a fucking stage like that, my nigga. You set a bad example of, like, future shit to come. And it's just a lot of, you know, just a lot of bullshit last night, to be real with you, man. Daylight stripping and fucking Royce talking about it was showmanship. My nigga, stripping on stage is not showmanship. Like, y'all niggas need, that shit is clown shit. So that shit was just corny, man. K-Slade walked off stage, Ebro going crazy. Yo, that shit was crazy. But as far as where they go from here, I'm not too impressed with Slaughterhouse. I'm gonna be real with you. That whole reality show almost seemed like it was some setup shit. No disrespect to Rex or nothing, but the judges wasn't right. To be real with you, I thought Disaster beat Daylight, so I don't even feel like Daylight should even been in the finals. But that's a whole nother story. Arsenal recycling rounds from like two different battles. That shit was corny. Niggas choking left and right. You at least got to give them more time to write and at least make the rounds longer. You know what I'm saying? I felt like that shit was rushed. I don't know how long Rex knew about this whole event. You know what I'm saying? I know that Cortez got cheated, but who knows? Rex could have known he was going to be in the house a whole, you know, a way long time ago. You know what I'm saying? Like, the nigga could have just been had bars on deck. But shout out to Rex. I know he normally is very prepared, but that shit just seemed like it was some setup shit, to be real with you. Or it don't seem as authentic as it could. They need to revamp that whole style. And as far as, like, when you had the biggest event, you do Joe Budden and Hollow to Don, Lux and Murder Mook, nigga, where do you go to from here? You know what I'm saying? UW is dealing with the same problem right now. They booked Lux and Hollow, and now they got O Solo and Tech N9ne. That's where you go. You know what I'm saying? Unless Total Slaughter is going to bring Meek Mill, Cassidy, Busta Rhymes. You know what I'm saying? This nigga Murder Mook is talking about he want $1 million to battle for his next battle. You know what I'm saying? And like, the way that nigga be talking sometimes, you don't even know if he trolling. Like, the nigga literally be, like, going through the roof with these prices. So that nigga gonna want some crazy amount of money to battle again, especially after beating Lux. So I don't know what matchups make sense. You know what I'm saying? I don't know, like, where Total Slaughter can go from here to actually do a battle event. the reality show shit, yeah, if they spread it around some, it could be dope if they put like Pat Stay, Real Deal, you know, maybe Chilla Jones, Hitman, Charlie Clip, DNA, Sharone. They got some couple names that can actually make the reality show good for next season. But as far as the main event, like, nigga, my nigga, what battles are left out there for a main event? What will sell out Hammerstein Ballroom that's out there? It really isn't anything, man, unless you bring mainstream artists in. And that shit ain't even a good look because the crowd doesn't fit the battle rap culture because you're bringing all these regular fans in mixed with battle rap fans. So, Total Slaughter, man, it was a good look. I'm not optimistic. Back to URL, back to King of the Dot, back to Spit That Heat, back to Guerrilla Warfare, back to RBE. That's where I'm at with it. Y'all can choose what y'all want to choose. I said in the beginning I was skeptical about this whole Total Slaughter and whether or not they were really in battle rap for the right reason. Maybe they wanted to promote Slaughterhouse. Maybe they wanted to drop an album. I'm still with that. I really think this whole Slaughterhouse shit been a failure from the event to the reality show. And the funny thing about it is if you go on their Twitter account, these niggas actually think their event is a success. Yo, they are getting killed in social media. They are dying behind social media right now. And they got the nerve to post how much of a success this event is.
Okay.
Because it made money? Oh, I get it. You make money, it's a success. Anyway, man, unbiased review, man. Holla at your boy.